Bio means life. Bio means life. Study about living organism, both plants and animals. Study about living organism, both plants and animals. Okay, it's called as biology. Okay, children. Now we are going to go in a new topic. Okay, see, our first topic is nutrition in plants. Okay, we are in this lesson, we are studying about plants. Before going to the chapter, listen carefully. What is food? What is meant by food? Every day we are getting food, isn't it? What is called as food? Why we are taking the food? Food is a substance which gives us energy, isn't it? All living organisms' basic need: food, air, water for the survival, isn't it? Plants also need food, air, and water. Animals also need food, air, and water, isn't it? So basic needs. Among these basic needs, food is very much essential, isn't it? So food, why we are in need of food? What the food gives us? We are utilizing food. What the food gives us? The food is the substance which uses energy. The substance which uses energy. The substance which uses energy is called food, isn't it? So, in this food, what are the substances present? You studied in 6th standard exam, isn't it? So, we are taking rice, dal, sambar, vegetables, fruits, everything. See, among this, what nutrient is present in it? In this food item, what nutrient is present in it? That we call as nutrients. The components. The content of the food, the components of food, the content of food, what the food contains is called as nutrients. What the food contains is called as nutrients. Okay, children, what the food contains is called as nutrients. What the food contains is called as nutrients. So the contains only, the another word is given, components of food. Okay. Here, what are the nutrients present in the food? First is carbohydrate. The nutrients present in the food, carbohydrate. Protein, fat, vitamin, and minerals. So these are the components of the carbohydrate. Protein, fat, vitamins, and minerals are the components of food. This we call as nutrients. Listen the terminology carefully. Nutrients. But our today's topic is nutrition. Okay. So what is meant by nutrition? We are going to see what is meant by nutrition. What is meant by nutrition? The mode of taking food by an organism. What is meant by this mode of taking food? See, listen. We are also taking food. The plants also taking food. way. In what way we are taking food? Whether the organism is able to prepare its own food or the organism cannot prepare its own food. On the basis of this, the nutrition is divided into two kinds. So on the basis of this, the nutrition is divided into two types. Whether the organism is able to prepare its own food or they depend on other living organisms, self-reliant or dependent. So the nutrition is divided into two main divisions, autotrophic. That means auto, self. The organism itself can prepare its own food. Or the organism cannot prepare its own food. Autotrophic. So autotrophic nutrition. Autotrophic nutrition. Clear, children? Self-oriented, dependent. So self-oriented. This kind of organism, the organism, the plant. Is the plant is depending for its food to any other organism? No. The plant itself can prepare its own food. We are not providing anything to the plant. The plant itself prepares its own food. So all the plants will come under autotrophic nutrition. Okay, auto means self, nourishment, trophic means nourishment, food. So autotrophic mode of nutrition, mode means way. Nutrition means mode of taking food by an organism. Whether the organism is able to prepare its own food or the organism is dependent on other. The organism is dependent on other living organism for its food. See, by animals and humans, we are taking food, plant, rice, vegetables, fruits, everything we are taking. Those things are plants, isn't it? We are dependent on other living organism for our food. So we are in heterotrophic mode of nutrition. We are in heterotrophic mode of nutrition. So humans and animals comes under heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Humans and animals comes under heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, children. So we are very clear on autotrophic mode of nutrition and heterotrophic mode of nutrition. So here we are going to learn a new terminologies. One is autotrophs. Autotrophs. That means the plants, the organism which undergo autotrophic nutrition is called as autotrophs. So plants are called as autotrophs. Here, the organism which undergo heterotrophic mode of nutrition, those organisms are called as heterotrophs. Heterotrophic nutrition. those things are going to come back. Parasitic, insectivorous.
Synthesis means making. So with the help of the sunlight,
the carbon dioxide. The carbon dioxide gas is absorbed by the plant through its leaves. Not from the root, not from the stem, through the leaves. So the air is absorbed through the leaves. Okay? In the leaves, we are respiring through our nose, no? Like that, in the leaves, there are many tiny pores. Tiny means small. In the leaves, there are many tiny pores. Tiny means small. Very small pores are present. Isn't it right? Many small pores are present. Those pores cannot, we can't see these pores as such. It can be seen through the microscope. Okay? That too, we have to take the leaf. The upper layer of the leaf should be peeled off. Then we kept in a slide like this. Then if we kept that inside the microscope, we can view the pores. We can't view the pores as such through our naked eyes. Naked means normal eyes. We can't view the pores which is present in the leaf. Then too, the pores are present in the backside of the leaf. Okay? So the leaf, the upper part of the leaf doesn't have many stomata pores, whereas in the lower part of the leaf have many pores. So those pores are called as stomata. Those pores are called as stomata. Okay? Now I'm going to draw that stomata in bigger view. Okay, so here only one leaf, so we can see the pores, tiny pores. Okay, the upper leaf part is cut out, peel lower layer of the peel, because in lower layer only many stomata pores are present. No, the peel is taken out and kept in the slide. Okay, I said this is the slide. Okay, then kept in the slide, and then if we view that pores in close up view, microscopic view, those pores look like this. Okay, those pores look like this. So this is the structure of cross section of the leaf. If I cut the leaf here, if I see through this side of the leaf, this side of the leaf, that section is given here, cross section of the leaf. Okay? That means upper layer of the leaf, upper epidermis, and lower layer of the leaf, lower epidermis. Okay? Then the pores. I said no pores. So those pores are named as stomata. Those pores are named as stomata. Okay, pores means pores, small pores. So the air, what is that? Carbon dioxide. So first raw material for the photosynthesis process is air. Air is taken through the stomata. Air is taken through the stomata. Okay, this is the structure of the stomata. See here, before going to deep into the stomata, there are two cells, guard cells, governing, protecting the pore. So those cells are called as guard cells. Here, this word is new to you. Know what is meant by cell and all? You don't know, isn't it? So for that, I'm giving you explanation about cell. Then we come back to this topic again. Okay? First we'll see what is cell. Then we come to that air, through which part of the plant absorbing air. which part of the plant absorbing water, and which part of the plant absorbing minerals, and which part of the plant absorbing sunlight. Okay, this we come later. First we will clarify the term cell. Okay, what is mean by cell? In 7th standard only you are coming to know about the term cell. See, cell diagram. If I take them here, peel of my skin or any plant part, small dot like peel. If I kept those peels under the microscope, this is called microscope, okay? So we can view here, magnifying lenses are there. Okay, about this microscope, you will study in your higher grades. So through that magnifying glass, we can view the magnifying view of the cell. If we take a small pinch of peel from the plant body or from animal or from humans, we find out many cells in it. More than thousands of cells may present in this. Okay, more than thousands of cells are present. Airways, buildings are made up of bricks, no? Like that, every living organism's body is made up of smaller unit called cell. Every living organism are made up of smaller unit called cell. Okay? So in this world there is a single cell organism. Only one cell is present. Such organism also there. Millions of cells. We have million, trillions of cells in our body. Okay? Every part is made up of cells. Okay? So this is the basic structure of the cell. This is the basic structure of the cell. Okay? What are the basic structure of the cell? See, each cell contains cell membrane. So imagine this is a cell. So in biology, any kind of thing, you should not draw in straight lines, okay? This free flow line, you draw like this. So each cell contains the outer boundary line. Cell contains outer boundary line and the inner one core material. This is the basic structure of the cell. See, this outer boundary line is called as cell membrane. Okay, the outer boundary line is called as cell membrane. The inner core material, I said, no, this only controls the activity of the cell. This only controls the activity of the cell. This is called as nucleus. This is called as nucleus. Then, jelly-like substance are present. The jelly-like substance are present here. This is called as cytoplasm. This is called as cytoplasm. Okay, so cell membrane, cytoplasm, and nucleus. Okay, so this is the basic structure of this. In this cytoplasm, many small organelles, parts present inside the cell are called as organelles. See, I said this itself, more than 100 cells are present. Imagine the size of the cell, imagine the size of the cell organelles. How minute organelles are present. Very much minute organelles are present in the cell. So, look here. So, this nucleus, cytoplasm, see, these are called as organelles of the cells. Both these organelles are not being see detail in 8th standard. See, among this organelle, that is the difference between a plant cell and animal cell. If I take a cell from the plant and and observe in the microscope, I can see one different organelle. That organelle is chloroplast. One special organelle is present in the plant is chloroplast. That is not there in the animals. That is the main difference between animals and plants. Between animal cell and plant cell. Chloroplast organelle is present in the plant cell. There is no chlorophyll in the animal cell. Okay. So, you know what is the basic structure of the cell wall. Okay. That means outer boundary line, compact line. Outer boundary line is called as cell membrane. Inside this core material, important material is called as nucleus. This nucleus only hold all the actions happens inside the cell and the cell organelles. And the cell organelles are suspended in the jelly-like substance called cytoplasm. This is the basic structure of the cell. Okay, now you will have the clear ideology about cell. Now we will come back to the topic, stomata. Okay, children, are you clear? So these are the raw materials needed for the photosynthesis: air, water, minerals, and sunlight. And of course, especially the carbon dioxide is absorbed by the stomata, stomatal core. See, look here. This hole. So the hole is present. These are the cells. This is one cell, and this is another cell. Okay. Very present underneath the leaf. This is the pore. Okay, pore. So this is pore. This pore only named as stomata. This pore only named as stomata. Listen, children. See, this is one cell and this is another cell. These two cells are protecting, governing, taking care of the pore. Okay, so this cell is called as God cell. Two cells, God cells. This cell is called as God cells. See, listen, like this, many number of tiny pores are there in ear leaf. Clear, children? So this is called as God cell, and this pore is called as stomata. Okay, so this God cell have, I said, cell organelles. Many parts are present in the cell. I said no, those parts are called as organelles. So the cell organelles contains, what is the main cell organelle present in the plant? Chloroplast. That is main cell organelle present in the plant is chloroplast. Chloroplast. So that chloroplast is present in the pore cell. Through the pore, through the stomata pore, carbon dioxide gas is absorbed, enter into the leaf for the process of photosynthesis. Okay, see, carbon dioxide gas is enter. And how the sunlight enters? coloring agents, the pigment called, that pigment is called as chlorophyll. Chlorophyll, okay, coloring pigment. That chlorophyll only green in color. That chlorophyll only green in color. That's why the plant looks green in color. That's why the leaf looks green in color. That's why the whole plants look green in color. So the chlorophyll pigment is present in the chloroplast organelle cell organelle. That is the reason this chlorophyll pigment is responsible for absorbing sunlight. For green photosynthesis, for preparing food, plants need air, water, minerals and sunlight, no? So the sunlight is being absorbed by the plant in the cells present in the pod cells, meaning chloroplasts are present inside the chloroplast. Chlorophyll pigment is present. That pigment is responsible for absorbing sunlight. Photo means sunlight, synthesis for making food. Okay, so we finish two things: carbon dioxide and sunlight. And sunlight, how it enters into the plant. See here, again I will bring that this is the section of the leaf, cross section of the leaf. There is a cross section, upper layer of the leaf, lower layer of the leaf. I already told you, in lower layer of the leaf only many stomatal pores are present. One of that stomatal pore only given in the microscopic view. Okay, see, this God cell have chloroplast in it. Inside the chloroplast only chlorophyll pigment is present. That pigment is responsible for absorbing sunlight. Okay, now we go to that. How the water is being absorbed? We have already seen how the water is being absorbed by the plant. Which part of the plant is responsible for absorbing water? Which part of the plant is responsible for absorbing water? See, what is this? Root, isn't it? See, in root, okay, this is plant. In root, through the root only, water and minerals are being absorbed. So, water and minerals are being absorbed by root. Water and minerals are being absorbed by root. What is present in the root? So, water and minerals are absorbed. It should be conducted, it should be transported to all the parts of the plant. Big trees also there, small shrubs also. Very small plants also there. Every plant, the root only is doing the absorption part, whereas the root have to conduct the water, transport the water, send the water to all other parts of the plant. To the every leaf of the plant, water should be reached. Then what is there inside the plant to transport this water? See, in the plant, there is a pipe-like structure is present in the stem. There is a pipe-like structure is present in the stem and root. That structure we called as, that structure only absorbs the water and minerals and supplies to all the leaves, all the parts of the plant. So that structure is called as vessels. That structure is called as vessels. So the pipe which supplies water, which transport water, is called as xylem vessels. which transport water is called as xylem itself, and which transport the minerals, foods, called as phloem results. Xylem results and phloem results. So through the pipette structure is present inside the stem. Those things will be responsible for transporting water which is being absorbed by the root and transported to every part of the plant. So the vessel which supplies water, which transport water is called as xylem. Which transport food is called as phloem. Clear children? Now we go. So now we study all this. So what are the raw materials needed for needed by the plants for preparing its own food is air, water, minerals and sunlight. So the plant prepares its own food. The process of preparing its own food by the plant is called as photosynthesis. So for this process, which part of the plant is helping? So now we will switch over to the next one. The photosynthesis is finished. Plant absorbs air, water and sunlight. It finished its work. What is the result of the work? So every work should have an end result. Now, what is the result of its work?
C6H12O6 molecular formula and
oxygen is released out. Okay, C6H12O6 carbohydrate and oxygen is released out by product during photosynthesis. During the daytime, plants take in carbon dioxide and gives out oxygen, and during this process it prepare its food called carbohydrate. Clear, children? So this is called as photosynthesis equation. This is called as photosynthesis equation. You can write like this also. CO2 plus H2O gives C6H12O6 plus O2, and it can be balanced. This balancing equation and all you will study in your higher classes. And simply writing, that means 6C or there. Like the balancing equation and all comes in your higher classes. Okay, so now we will go to the next one.
Nodes means
முடிஞ்சு நாட் லைக் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர்ஸ் ஆர் பிரசன்ட் தோஸ் நாட்ஸ் ஆர் கால்ட் அஸ் நாட்யூல்ஸ் ரூட் நாட்யூல்ஸ் ரூட் நாட்யூல்ஸ் தோஸ் நாட் லைக் முடிஞ்சு ஸோ தோஸ் ஆர் கால்ட் அஸ் ரூட் நாட்யூல்ஸ் வாட் இஸ் திஸ் ரூட் நாட்யூல்ஸ் இஸ் தட் த பார்ட் ஆஃப் அ பிளான்ட் நோ த ரூட் நாட்யூல்ஸ் ஆர் நாட் த பார்ட் ஆஃப் த பிளான்ட் இட்ஸ் எ கைண்ட் ஆஃப் பாக்டீரியா த பாக்டீரியா group of bacteria stick together and form a knot-like structure in the root. So the group of bacteria only forms this knot-like structure in the root. In which kind of plants? I said the plants which prepare protein food. So the plants which prepare protein food are called as leguminous, leguminous plants. So the plants which prepare protein food, all the pulses plant, parutu, all the pulses plants are called as leguminous plants. Okay, so in this plant root, the root nodules are present. The root nodules are nothing but a bacterial groups. Only makes the nodule-like structure. What name of that bacteria? What is the name of that bacteria? Is Rhizobium. What is the name of that bacteria? Is Rhizobium. The name of that bacteria is Rhizobium. See, I am giving the Rhizobium in a single Rhizobium. It is very minute organ. We can't see the Rhizobium like this. It can be seen through the electron. This is what is simply the, this is the compound microscope. Okay, three, four magnifying glasses on them, lenses, magnifying lenses on them. Whereas in electron microscope only, we can view a structure of rhizobium like this. Okay, and this rhizobium is having the capacity, the rhizobium which is present in the roots of the leguminous plants, pulses plants, protein giving plants. Okay. The root, the rhizobium bacteria is having the capacity to absorb the atmospheric nitrogen. It's having the capacity to absorb the atmospheric nitrogen. Okay, gaseous form of nitrogen. Absorbing the gaseous form of nitrogen. Gaseous form of nitrogen. And the nitrogen is converted by the rhizobium into soluble form. Soluble form of nitrogen by this rhizobium. That soluble form of nitrogen is absorbed by the root nodules. The rhizobium is present in the root only, no? So the rhizobium is transforming the gaseous nitrogen into soluble nitrogen. Now the plant is able to absorb the soluble form of nitrogen and it absorbing and is conducting, transferring that to the plant. So, for preparing protein food, plant are in need of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen. Nitrogen also now with the help of rhizobium, plant is absorbing. Okay, the rhizobium is a bacteria which is converting the gaseous nitrogen into soluble nitrogen. So by this way, this bacteria is helping the plant, leguminous plant, protein giving plant, pulses plants are called as leguminous plants. The rhizobium is present there. Okay, children. So apart from that, carbohydrates, nutrient. What are the nutrients are prepared by the photosynthesis? One is carbohydrate, another one is protein. And another one is fat. Okay. The higher plants do photosynthesis. Okay, preparing food like this. While doing photosynthesis, higher plants are preparing photosynthesis. What happened to the lower level of plants? See, in stagnant water body, we can see, in stagnant water body, we can see algae are present on the water surface. Algae are present in a stagnant water body, isn't it? Those algae also plants. Those algae also plants. So that algae are absorbing the light, sunlight, and that algae also have chloroplast in it. Those algae also have chloroplast, pass on stagnant water. Tangi irukra neer. In stagnant water bodies, algae are there in the surface water. In overhead tank, side walls also, many algae are living, isn't it? So those algae are also comes under plant. Okay, so those cells of algae are having chloroplast in it. Here I given two examples of algae, Chlamydomonas spirovera. In stagnant water bodies, these algae are present. These are microscopical view of the algae. Algae are always clumped together in colony formats. Okay, so this is Chlamydomonas. What is this? So look at the cell of the Chlamydomonas. See this green part. This green part is what? Chloroplast. Okay, chloroplast. With the help of the chloroplast, the plant, that the algae body is preparing photosynthesis and preparing its own food. Okay, children. So now shall we see the recap of this lesson? First, what we see in the starting of the lesson, what we see is, what is nutrients? Components of food is called as nutrients. What are they? Carbohydrate, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. Then we will see what is the definition for nutrition. Mode of taking food by an organism. Mode of taking food by an organism. So this topic is nutrition in plants. So how the plants are taking its food? By autotrophic nutrition, and some plants are by heterotrophic nutrition. What is it by autotrophic nutrition? The plants can prepare its own food. It's called as autotrophs. The organism which can prepare its own food are called as autotrophs. The organism which depend on other organism for its food is called as heterotrophs. In plants also, some plants or few plants are in heterotrophic mode of nutrition. That means see, okay, so nutrition in plants, autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. Autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. As in plants prepare its own food. Okay, so this we'll see one more clarity here, because we are in 7th standard. So one more simple clarity I'm giving. So some plants which are the plants are in need of sunlight to do the photosynthesis. So here this autotrophic nutrition is can be divided into two categories. One is photoautotrophic. Photosynthesis is doing, no? Photoautotrophic. Another one is forest plants. Next class. Thank you, children. Hope you are all be safe.